Real estate is often an asset on the minds of people retiring, whether downsizing or moving into a maintenance-free lifestyle. We have Jonathan McCoy of Market Advisory Group in studio to give his thoughts on how to manage real estate. Jonathan, can the proceeds of a real estate sale be rolled over, or what are ways that we can mitigate taxes in the event of a real estate sale?
Well, I like to use some real-life examples. We've had several folks this year, especially that have been contemplating, do we sell our primary residence, maybe even move into some sort of rental property?
Mm-hmm.
The important things to keep in mind there is, especially in your primary residence, there are some major tax benefits that the IRS provides to make sure that you're not getting hit with a huge, heavy tax load if you've had a lot of growth in the value of your home while you've been living there. I had a gal just a couple of weeks ago that she retired, sold her home, and we were able to roll her equity from her home into an asset and investment that's going to pay her not just what she needs to make her rent payment, but actually some additional income every month, essentially for the rest of her life, to make sure that that new living arrangement that she's got moving from a home ownership to a rental is something that's sustainable for 20, 30, 40 years to come.
So whether a person has made a living with rental properties or they have just had, you know, one or two with the run-up in housing prices, is now a good time to diversify out of real estate holdings?
It could be a good consideration, assuming that we're close to, if not right at the high in all-time real estate values. We know that housing costs are exorbitant right now, but if you've been a real estate investor and had those rental properties, it's important to plan for and account for the tax ramifications. Our tax team is specialized in making sure you can minimize the taxes upon the sale, but also you have to think about sort of a three-step process. What are the tax implications? How can you minimize the taxes? But then also, how does that equity get reinvested to make sure that you can continue a stream of income or make sure that that money is continuing to grow essentially for the rest of your retirement?
And so when a person does sell off that rental property, how can they make up for the loss of income?
So reinvestment, I just used an example on your first question of how do you move that money into something that's still going to provide you the income that you need. We have to look very closely at what your budget's going to be, how much money you expect to spend throughout retirement. And diversification is a great thing. Having all your money wrapped up in real estate can be risky if we're assuming that there's going to be some deflation or potentially lowering in those real estate assets here over the next 4 or 5 years. But we have to look at where does the money get reinvested and what kind of income source can be generated from that to help meet your budget needs.
And this week we do have a viewer question. This one is from JD. JD writes, my family is in line to inherit real estate. How do I plan for it, or what are some of the things to be aware of upon that inheritance?
So I go back to that three-step process. So especially from an inheritance, it could be tricky to understand what are the tax implications. Do your benefactors, whether it's your parents or someone else in the family that's giving that real estate to you and your maybe your siblings, or how it's going to be split up. Do they have an estate plan in place to make sure that the money does get split evenly between everyone that's supposed to be getting that asset, and what are the tax ramifications? So then the second step is then what do you do with that money after you've inherited? How does that become part of your portfolio? How are you mitigating the taxes over time? But mostly maximizing income from those inheritances, especially on real estate, is a key focus, and that's something that we plan for every day in our consultations.
Wonderful. Jonathan, thanks for being here today.
Thanks a lot.
Absolutely. And to schedule a complimentary consultation and submit your questions, visit AskOurAdvisor.com or call 816-548-2000. They'll take your questions and even meet one-on-one free of charge. And if you include your address, Market Advisory Group will even send you a free gift.